The 4th of July is not ordinarily the most popular holiday in Britain, but this year there was cause to celebrate. The country's pubs opened for the first time in nearly 3 months after coronavirus lockdowns. In London, however, people ignored appeals for social distancing and police had to disperse drunken crowds. Here's special correspondent Malcolm Brabant.
Judy, like many other Brits, I'm enjoying my first pint of beer in a pub for over 100 days. At first, the government here thought that the restoration of normal services had gone well, but over the weekend there came reports of several episodes of bad behaviour, which, if repeated, could jeopardise elements of Britain's recovery. My report begins in the city of Nottingham, made famous by the legendary outlaw Robin Hood. At the 780-year-old Salutation Inn, jeweller Sue Dyer celebrated what was dubbed Britain's Independence Day. Her choice of beverage was appropriate.
There's a lot of people who felt very isolated, who will be struggling with this, so it's nice that they can get out. Everybody's gone to a lot of effort to keep people safe, lots of social distances. Everybody who we've come across so far has been very sensible about things.
Jason Weston runs this, one of the oldest pubs in the world. It's witnessed the 14th century Black Death and the 17th century Great Plague. With COVID-19 still lurking, Weston wants to be on the right side of history.
We are being very, very on point. We can't risk the safety of our staff, the safety of our customers. You know, if you're foolish and you don't follow the guidelines, all that's going to happen is we're going to end up being shut down again.
Weston trusted his patrons not to get hammered.
It wasn't the drinking they were missing. You know, they're missing the social aspect of what pubs are.
Car dealer David Wakeling concurred.
Just now being here with friends, having a beer, you know, these simple things that you take for granted, when you lose that ability, when you lose that chance to have that, to come out and to feel almost freedom, it's one of those liberties that we stand for.
Prime Minister Boris Johnson knew it was a gamble, but he lifted the lockdown to revive Britain's drowning economy.
Good evening. Anyone who flouts social distancing and COVID secure rules is not only putting us all at risk, but letting down those businesses and workers who have done so much to prepare for this new normal.
But the appeal was ignored almost immediately in London's Soho district. In another part of the capital, police retreated when they tried to break up a block party and were pelted with bottles. In Nottingham, some self-restraint was also liquidated. Some pubs remained closed and not all out of choice. Despite installing social distancing measures, including booths in his beer garden, landlord Alan Merriweather was unable to open his doors. The reason? His pub is in Leicester, the only city in Britain subjected to a regional lockdown because of a major spike in infections.
Everyone was looking forward to the 4th of July. My staff were prepared. The financial implications has hit us quite hard. It's been devastating.
Health officials have identified the source of the spike in a poor neighbourhood, mainly home to people with Asian heritage. Emergency testing centres were set up by the army, but residents appear to be staying away. Police guarded the railway station to stop people leaving for nearby cities like Nottingham so they could go to the pub. Willie Bark is Leicester's police commissioner, the civilian overseer of the local force.
The British way of policing is by consent, and that's really important. Vital freedoms are being taken away from people, and so it's very important that the law doesn't come down so hard on them.
Among other things, the 4th of July marked the opening of museums in Nottingham's Robin Hood experience. Its actors entertained visitors with the legend of the medieval outlaw, who, with his merry men, robbed the rich and donated the proceeds to the poor.
There's something very much in the British psyche about standing up to problems and coming together to fight it. And this time we're being told to stay apart and do nothing. The best thing you can do is do nothing. And that really has gone against the grain for a lot of people.
There's a lot of angry people out there, there's a lot of scared people out there, and I think getting small independent businesses back on the streets is really, really important for Nottingham, as it is for a lot of different places. It's been terrifying, really, really terrifying.
The government had hoped the nation would adopt a more sensible rhythm after nearly 45,000 deaths. But there are now widespread fears that Britain's drinking culture could wreck the advances that have been made. So important are pubs here that Prince William felt obliged to have a pathfinding sip of cider. But he's not as thirsty as the average Brit. Sales manager Andy Durs.
I'm 34, I'm relatively healthy, I'm relatively fit. Am I concerned about it? Not really, no, I'm not. You know, I would like to continue my life as though it was normal. I think people talk about the new normal. I think, knowing human beings the way I do, the new normal will be normal because people are creatures of habits and will continue the way they always did.
It'll take a week or so before Britain discovers whether Independence Day was really Incubation Day. If so, parts of the country could soon be back under lock and chain. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Nottingham.